Some time ago, I saw a report on Korean descendants in Yucatan, who were having a Korean name ceremony to reconnect with their roots. I knew at that point that Korean names are chosen as a wish to give the child certain virtues, good luck, etc., so that their names can guide them in life, rather than just be pretty like we do in this part of the world. With that article, I also learned that Korean names are chosen to reflect the history of a family beyond just passing on a last name, like they do when they pass on first name syllables or integrate a name that matches the meaning of their last name. All of this made me want to have a Korean name. I've realized some parents go for a more occidental take and name their children based on what they think will be cute and pretty. So names like Sadang, which means love, are not uncommon. And every time I hear them, I wonder if those names are meant to be a reminder of something, like an unspoken love letter from their parents, or a guide for their lives, like the traditional ones. So far, I've only seen Sadang being used for females, never for males. And with this in mind, I came across the word Chong, that also means love and affection. But different from Sadang, this one has a third meaning, bond. So I started thinking of all the idols whose name has a Jung, like Yang Jong-in from Stray Kids and Yoo Jong-yeon from Twice. And I wonder if it was a way for parents to show them their love, but in a more subtle way, or to wish them to be surrounded by love, affection, and strong bonds throughout their lives. Either way, for what I'm able to see in the glimpses they share from their lives, I think it worked. I still don't have a Korean name. I've struggled so much trying to get one because I've been trying to do it the Occidental way. But now, after all I've learned and seen, I think I need to focus on what I want for my life, the virtues I want to have, the aspects I want to see prosper later on, and maybe also the legacy I want to leave behind.